السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين، أما بعد. So today, inshallah ta'ala, is the beginning of the Hijjah, the beginning of the best 10 days in the entire year, as the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said in his hadith. And when he talks about these 10 days, he said, فَأَكْثِرُوا فِيهَا مِنَ التَّهْلِيلِ وَالتَّكْبِيرِ. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam emphasized on one type of ibadah. Of course, we should all kinds of ibadat during these 10 days. But he mentioned this specifically one type of ibadah, one type of worship during these first 10 days, and that is ذكرullah subhanahu wa ta'ala. التَّهْلِيلِ وَالتَّكْبِيرِ وَالتَّحْمِيدِ, which is saying لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا اللَّهِ, Allahu Akbar, and Subhanallah, Alhamdulillah, all kinds of dhikr. The scholars commented on this specific part of the Prophet's statement, emphasizing on the dhikr during these 10 days. They said that since these 10 days are considered as the best days of the year, and everyone is supposed to take advantage of them, so the Prophet ﷺ said dhikr. Why did he say dhikr? Because it is the easiest type of ibadah. Anyone can do it. Some people can fast, some other people cannot fast. Some people can give any charity, some people might not be able to give any charity. Some people might be doing the hajj, other people might not be able to do it. But when it comes to dhikr, which is Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, La ilaha illallah, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, wa lillahi alhamd, la ilaha illallah, subhanallah, alhamdulillah. This is the easiest type of ibadah. So it seems that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives the chance to every single person, to every single Muslim during these 10 days to get closer to Him. Because there will be no excuse for anyone not to get closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, at least with the what? With the dhikr. So this is the easiest type of ibadah, and that's why we should take advantage of it. The other thing related to the first 10 days of the month of Hijjah, we know that as of today, until the Asr of the day of Al-Tashriq, or the third day of Al-Tashriq, which is the fourth day of the Eid, we make the takbir. And the takbir is Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, La ilaha illallah, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, wa lillahi alhamd. This takbir is two types. There's takbir that is known as takbir mutlaq, general takbir, and there is takbir that is known as takbir muqayyad. Takbir mutlaq, which can be made at any time. You make it during daytime, nighttime, after the salah, before the salah. It doesn't matter when you do it. So it's not connected with a certain time to do it. It's not connected with a certain time to do it. By the way, it is the same type of takbir, which is Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, La ilaha illallah, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, wa lillahi alhamd. The takbir that we normally say on the Eid. So this type of takbir, the formula of the takbir is the same. But the general one, or the mutlaq takbir, can be said at any time. The other type of takbir is called muqayyad. Muqayyad means it's connected with a certain time. And this takbir muqayyad is the takbir that is made after the obligatory salah, after the five daily prayers. So the takbir mutlaq, to say takbir, daytime, nighttime, before salah, after the salah, start from today until the asr of the third day of al-tashriq. The takbir muqayyad, which should be said specifically after every obligatory salah, start from the Fajr of the day of Arafah until the Asr of the third day of Al-Tashriq. So we should not restrict the takbir during the first 8 days to after the Salah. We can say it at any time. But starting from the day of Arafah until the fourth day of the Eid, the Asr of the fourth day of the Eid, we should make the takbir specially after the Salah. Now the question is, from the day of Arafah until the last day of Al-Tashriq, or the fourth day of the Eid, can we also make the takbir other than after the Salah? Yani we are recommended to do it after the Salawat. Can we do it also in other times? Yes. So what is the difference? The difference is, during the day of Arafah all the way until the last day of Tashriq, it is confirmed and it is strongly recommended to do it specifically after the Salah, the five obligatory prayers. So two things, the dhikr of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, so easy during these days. The second one, make sure to make takbir as much as you can. Get closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah says in the Quran, وَالْفَجْرِ وَلَيَالٍ عَشْرٍ. And he says, لِيَشْهَدُوا مَنَافِعَ لَهُمْ وَيَذْكُرُوا اسْمَ اللَّهِ فِي أَيَّامٍ مَعْلُومَاتٍ. نسأل الله سبحانه وتعالى أن ينفعنا بهذه الأيام المباركة. Ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to benefit us from these blessed days as we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us from those who listen to the words and follow the best of them. اللهم اغفر لنا ذنوبنا واستر عيوبنا واشرح صدورنا وبلغنا مما يرضيك آملنا. اللهم إنا نسألك الهدى والتقى والعفاف والغنى ومن العمل ما ترضى برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين. وصل اللهم وسلم وبارك على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. سبحانك اللهم وبحمدك أشهد أن لا إله إلا أنت أستغفرك وأتوب إليك. والعصر إن الإنسان لفي خسر إلا الذين آمنوا وعملوا الصالحات وتواصوا بالحق وتواصوا بالصبر. جزاكم الله خيرا.